Hey everyone, welcome back to the workbench. Today we're going to be looking at the 2003 Smart Roadster kit by Burago. So this kit here is 1:24 scale. Skill, not sure on skill level, but it's rated for ages 8 and older. Detail on the box showing that it has opening doors and hood. Here's the other kits that were available during the time. And according, not sure when this was made, but my guess would have been about mid-2000s. Set code number 55074. Painted in yellow. I'll open it up, see what's inside. Okay, got nice detailed instructions. Special, got your sticker sheets. You have directions on how stuff's put together. Big fold out instructions. And just a bunch of information about the kit itself. Now look, going through the parts. Here we have wheel and tires. And a bunch of suspension pieces. Everything's all looks really nicely done. The windshield. With the black line already pre-done. Something that's not in the bag. We have the top half of the engine molded to the interior. Here's what looks like to be some of the interior pieces, plus the outer accessories. Here's some more interior pieces, plus the rear window. Here's the chrome tree with just accessory pieces with headlights, pedals, license plate brackets, and then you have tail lights right here. More interior, some other accessories, like you have here the dash. You have the dash, two-piece seats. Then the small little three-cylinder engine the car would have came with transmission mounted. Now here's the chassis. There's not much detail underneath. Just has where it's main, then scale size. Some more pieces. Second half of the interior parts, and then you also have the roof. Then here you have the light. Right here you have the lights. Possible interior handles, brake discs, some other parts, polished aluminum. Here you have the side panels and top portion. And what come. You also get this really nice. You get a display stand for your model when you're done, which is a nice touch. You could probably use it for other builds if you really want to. Then here's that metal body. Here's the metal body, which is rather heavy, surprisingly enough. Get out of the bag, take a look at it. Now, the windshield, yeah, everything here is all metal. It's got some decent weight to it. Opening doors. And opening trunk, which in this case would be the hood. It's nice detail to it. Yeah, and that seems to be it for everything. So, this being a simple kit, I'm going to do a quick build up, and then afterwards show off what I've got. Then hopefully being able to do everything all in one video. Continuing off with the builds, and you realize a few things that you might want to know about when building a Burago kit. First one being with how with the windshield, what you pretty much need to do is fits in like that, clicks into the top of the pillar, and then you have the visor, just clicks into the top, you have the visor, just clicks in up top. And something else to notice, when the body is all one, you have the door words inside the crease. You might think that's normal, but when you put the interior panels in, as so here, you will realize that the door doesn't line up, and it looks really awkward, and you don't know if it's because of the pieces. But what it actually is when you have the exterior chrome, the aluminum pieces, I guess, that would end up covering up this whole area. So you would have a flush body line. And as you can see here for the door line, everything lines up perfectly. Opens and closes nicely. And then then something with the seats. When you're putting these together, you have the backrest, and with this, you have to slide it underneath in order to get together. And then when you got that, you have to forcefully push it together to become flush, and then you have. Then that's where you have the backing to go behind. Which brings me to the second thing you have to realize with this kit. Is there's a left and right seat. So you have where the seatbelt loop, where this would be on the passenger side. And this would be on the driver's side. So you want to make sure you don't confuse those. Then you also got, and what else here? Oh yes, and then we have the lenses, specifically the front ones. They're two-piece, and depending on what you do, it can be rather tight to get both the lens and the bezel all together as one. So it does require a lot. So that does involve a lot of pressing, trying to get everything to connect, and trying to get it all perfectly installed into the plastic front here, which will click in and install. And then for the tail lights, this kit here includes decals for the lights. Which I was testing them out to see how it is, but realistically, you probably want to paint those for a more aesthetically pleasing model. So, that's what I got for now. We'll get near completing the model. Okay, so just about done the build. So here's so far what I've got on the car. There still needs some decals that need to go on. The one problem I do have is where the aluminum comes around, it doesn't quite fit in properly, so I'm definitely going to see about that later on. And then on the back, everything went together fine. The trunk is another story. It's a little bit difficult to get in. You have to get underneath, get the tabs to click in. And with that, you get the trunk with the hood all in one unit. Then you have door panels. I thought there was like some sort of window piece that goes into here to cover up the hole, but from what I've been going through the bags, that isn't the case. So next off, we have the chassis with the engine. So the underside here, piece just wraps around to connect. Then you have the wheel axle, then you have the front axle, which does turn. Then here's the interior. Got the accessories put in. Now what I'm going just need to be doing now is with the dash. All I'm needing now is just to put everything together. And then we'll just connect through here. Go on the chassis like this. Of course, being all together. So this would end up join here. Just connecting through. Now, you will have an extra of the brake lens, and so far, if you want to, you can have the license plates, which I'm definitely going to add, just need the license plate themselves. Then, for decals, there's a few here that I'm not quite sure what the deal is with these, but just extra detail, I guess. So, yeah, so far it's a decent build. Going to be looking forward to it done. So, see you in the next update. Now here we have the model all completed. It's quite a simple build. The only problem I've had was pretty much just getting some pieces together, but could always be a builder's fault. So far it's all really nice. The display stands really nice. There is no glass case that goes with this, so that's a little bit unfortunate. So here's the car. Functioning steering. All the tires spin. Got the opening doors. Then you have cargo space. Cargo space with the engine underneath. Yeah, so good little build. And this here is a 1/24 scale. So it's bigger than the 1/25 scales you get with other kits. And for a size comparison, here's a Revell 1/25 scale Viper that I built a while ago. So it seems like that the cars are pretty much close to the exact same size when in reality, this one here would be a lot smaller than the Viper. But of course it's whatever. So yeah. I decided not to go for a license plate, but you have the choice if you want to. good little build. I wouldn't quite say this is my first metal kit, but surely I'm going to be building more, hopefully, if come across some more. So I'll leave it with that for tonight, guys, and thank you for watching, and see you in the next review.